Hello everyone, welcome to Shake Hand with Life. I am Narendra Sharma. In my previous two videos, we have studied two tail test, left tail test and right tail test for hypothesis testing. The critical values separating rejection region and acceptance region for null hypothesis. In relation to that, there is one more important concept, which is the calculation of p-value and the rule of accepting or rejecting a null hypothesis on the basis of p-value. And therefore, in this video, we will study what is p-value and how to calculate p-value in case of two-tailed test, left-tailed test and right-tailed test. But before moving in this video, I recommend you watch the videos of two-tailed test, left-tailed test and right-tailed test for hypothesis testing in case if you haven't watched them yet, to better understand the concept of p-value. The links are given in the I mark above and in the description below. Now starting with what is p-value. The p-value is the probability of obtaining a value of test statistic as extreme or more than extreme than the actual value obtained when the null hypothesis is true. Or in simple terms, given a null hypothesis and sample evidence with sample size n, the p-value is the probability of getting a sample evidence that is equally or more unfavorable to the null hypothesis while the null hypothesis is actually true. Therefore, p-value is the kind of credibility rating of H0 or null hypothesis in the light of evidence, and hence the p-value is the smallest level of significance alpha at which the null hypothesis may be rejected using the obtained value of test statistic. Now come to the rule of rejecting or accepting a null hypothesis on the basis of p-value. The rule of rejecting or accepting a null hypothesis is, if the p-value is less than alpha, then reject the null hypothesis. And if p-value is greater than alpha, then accept the null hypothesis. The analogy you can use to remember, if p is less, then say no to null. And if p is high, then say yes to null. For example, if the value of alpha fixed at 5% and the p-value comes as less than 5%, then the H0 or null hypothesis will be rejected. And if p-value comes as greater than 5%, then H0 or null hypothesis will be accepted. Now let's try to understand with an example. In case of a left tail test, the p-value is the area to the left of the calculated value of the test statistic. Suppose the calculated value of z is -2.00, then the area to the left of it using table area under the standard normal distribution is 0.5 -0.4772. This will come as 0.0228. Hence the p-value is 2.28%. Here, at an alpha of 5%, the null hypothesis will be rejected because the p-value is less than 5%. In case of a right tail test, the p-value is the area to the right of the calculated value of the test statistic. Suppose the calculated value of z comes out +1.75, then the area to the right of it using the table area under the standard normal distribution is 0.5 -0.4599, and this will come as 0.0401. Hence the p-value is 4.01%. Here also, at an alpha of 5%, the null hypothesis will be rejected because p-value is less than 5%. Now in case of a two-tailed test, p-value is twice the tail area. If the calculated value of the test statistic falls on the left tail, then we take the area to the left of the calculated value and multiply by 2. If the calculated value of the test statistic falls on the right tail, then we take the area to the right of the calculated value and multiply it by 2. For example, if the calculated value of z comes out as +1.75, then the area to the right of it is 0.0401. Now multiplying that by 2, we get the p-value as 0.0802 or 8.02%. Here, at an alpha of 5%, the null hypothesis will be accepted because the p-value is greater than 5%. Now do this exercise by yourself. If the test statistic comes as z equal to -1.86, then find the p-value for a hypothesis test in case of left tail test, right tail test and two tail test. Also find in which of these three cases will H0 be rejected at an alpha of 5%. Write your answer in the comment box below for all these three cases. That's all in this video. If you have any question or suggestions, then please do write your feedback in the comment box below. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. Click here to subscribe Shake Hand with Life YouTube channel and press the bell to receive notifications of my latest videos. Click here to visit on shakehandwithlife.in to download the course notes and ebooks in PDF. Thanks for watching. See you soon in my next video with a new topic.